groups or Germanic tribes. But in the 9th century, North African Muslims, they reach Sicily. Sicily, very much conquered by Muslims around 828, it remained under Muslim control until the 14th century. So Islam remained around 500 years in Sicily. And the population of Sicily was very much 50-50, Muslim and Catholic. And what we are, what also we know of, when the population structure of Sicily changes around 15th century, that is another issue because of major migration from it, from Albania to Sicily, because of the Islamization of Albania, some of the Catholics moved to Sicily, and according to some scholars, it's a controversial issue about the origin of mafia in Sicily. Some people link to root of mafia to Albania, that these Albanian clan families very much moved from Albania to Sicily, and they were the one to first develop the mafia network or mafia culture. Islam very much shaped the architecture of Sicily, and later on some of the Muslims moved to Italy as well, but it very much remained a Sicilian phenomena in the sense that Islam remained more dominant in Sicily, and the agriculture very much. The Arabs were quite good in terms of irrigation system and some of the water development, because the water was very limited in the Arabian Peninsula, and they developed an incredible technology in that period to purify the water in terms of creating irrigation system to carry water to different areas. And the agriculture of Sicily, in terms of the architecture of Sicily, very much punctuated by this North African Islam. Again, it's a North African Islam is somewhat different than Arabian Peninsula of Islam, that we all talk about one Islam, but in fact, there is one message of God, but there are very different understanding of that message, and there are also very different contextualization of that universal message of Islam. They're similar to the Mexican Catholics are not similar to Polish Catholic, or Polish Catholics are very different than the Irish Catholics or the Italian Catholics. The local culture very much mixed with the message of God and creates its own coloring. Same way Islam, that the North Africa somewhat had more tolerant, more relaxed version of Islam than the Arabian Peninsula. And this version of Islam became dominant in Sicily, and Palermo especially, very much the Berbers from North Africa still, Algeria and Morocco today, as you know, have large number of Berber population, and they also have their own language. The Islam very much put to an end in Italy around, the decline starts around the 11th century, but in the 13th century, the Sicily very much controlled by the Christian again. The Muslims had two options, conversion or to exit. And what we are seeing both happened at the same time. Some Muslims converted to Christianity, some did not convert and moved out to North Africa, some, according to stories, moved to Albania, and because when the Ottoman Turks reached Albania, there were some Islamic institutions, the mosque, in Albania. And there's another story which is linked to this early Islamic presence in Bosnia. The Bosnia Slavic population, some converted these Slavs, converted and became Catholic. Those who converted to the Catholic Church, they are called Croatian or Hrvat. Some converted to Greek Orthodox, they are the Serbs. In between, there was a Bogomil church. The Bogomil church was neither Catholic nor Orthodox, but somewhat influenced by Islam. And some people, some scholars argue that the Islam, today's Bosnia, was introduced by the Sicilian Muslims. Because of the pressure there, some of them moved to Albania, to Montenegro, then Travnik. It was the major city before Sarajevo, had some influence on the Bogomil church, and so the Bosnian population in the middle was not alien to Islam when Turks came. So the conversion did not take place because of the Turks came to Balkans, but there was a religious fermentation mixing going on in the Balkans before the Turks reached, because of, again, this Islamic presence in Sicily, and because of the pressure there, some of them had to move. So this migration of religions or migration of ideas and populations are not something new. The Mediterranean, people usually consider Mediterranean as one cultural zone, because there was an incredible exchange. There was incredible degree of population movement, movement of the goods and ideas and religions and all kinds of things. Let me move to 15th century, because it is very important, being a Turk. So I need to talk about the 15th century, because the 15th century, when again the Muslim, this time not to Sicily, but under the Ottoman Sultan Mehmed, who after the, during the conquest of Albania and Bosnia, there were Turkish Ottoman attempt to penetrate Italy. And in fact, in after the conquest of Constantinople, what is today called Istanbul in 1453, it also used to be called the Second Rome or the second important center of Christianity in terms of the Orthodox Church. As you know, there was tension between Vatican and Constantinople. And there was an attempt in 1499 to control, to in military engagement in Italy. Otranto was conquered by the Ottoman Turks in 1503. That the Ottomans had a military presence in Italy, and they start to move inside. Well, they had first during the Mehmed period, but they managed to keep some part on the seashore under the Ottoman control. But after the death of the Sultan, and because of the problems also in Hungary, because the Ottomans were expanding, today's Bihać, or the frontier between Bosnia-Herzegovina and Croatia, was the main frontier of the Ottoman Empire. The Muslims also, the Ottoman Muslims tried to, main goal was the, at that time, Rome, to conquer Rome by sending troops over the land, over the Croatia and down there. But that did not succeed that much. Also, the Ottomans had a number of problems, but because of the second siege of Vienna, very much was a turning point of Ottoman expansion. In the Vienna Second Siege of the Vienna, Ottoman troops were